It's Madden NFL 24 on EA Sports. And the question is, are you ready for some football? It's the Chicago Bears and the Atlanta Falcons. All that and more coming up next.
First opened in 2017, there's a look at the beautiful state-of-the-art Mercedes-Benz Stadium here in Atlanta, GA. Straight ahead, we've got a pretty good one on tap here as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Atlanta Falcons. Along with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and for both of these teams that we're going to see, Charles, the future is kind of right now. You know, this is something you only see a handful of times in an NFL season where you've got a rookie quarterback versus a rookie quarterback.
And I think a lot of that has to do with the era we're in now, because our dads, they didn't see rookie quarterbacks go against each other. In fact, it could be 2-3 years before they even saw the playing field. Nowadays, you get drafted, they expect you to play earlier, and these guys as competitors, they'll take their lumps early, but they'd rather be on the field.
Here's Cairo Santos now, ready to get this one started. And we are underway from Atlanta. From out of his end zone, it's Avery Williams. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. And they will be led out by a guy certainly still trying to prove himself here in the league, the young rookie quarterback.
I tell you what, when he is on schedule for that week, secondaries take notice because you've got to stay alert back there on every snap. A truly powerful arm, one that's capable of challenging any level of the defense on any given play. That's why so many scouts preach arm talent when preparing for the NFL draft. A quarterback with arm strength to make every throw in the book, he's an asset to have in any offense.
Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 19 yards right off the bat, and a quick first down.
And time to get to the big fellas, the offensive line here, because you've got to have good protection on crossing routes, because you've got to give your receiver time to work all the way across the field. That time, able to scan the field, spot his receiver moving left to right, and make a good, accurate throw. Thank you, guys.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete. He shook his head right when he released that throw. He knew it was going to be a little off target.
Yeah, the excitement got him on that one. Wasn't able to control the fact the receiver was open, and it would have been an easy throw.
So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. He'll drop to throw. Over the middle, caught by London. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
So into Bear territory now. This is first and 10 at the 46. A run for the first time with Bijan Robinson as he's got this down inside the 40 to the 39. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3. The success there, Charles, coming on the outside of the field, the ground game. Curious to see if that continues as we progress.
Yeah, we often talk about a variety in play calling and usually between run and pass. But in this case, with strictly the run game, you can be creative there as well. Run it inside, run it outside, keep the defense off balance.
Now left side, the completion is tight end. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears' 27-yard line. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. That early game script that they drew up is working pretty well here on this first drive. Already in field goal range, Charles, knocking on the door of the red zone.
You know, Brandon, when we met with the coaching staff, they kind of predicted that they would come out firing like this. I think you and I were a little skeptical it would be this easy, but they certainly knew what they were doing in scouting, in preparation, and understanding what their team was capable of.
So just 3 yards on the completion there, and that'll bring up second down.
Let's get the yards, boys.
Now they'll throw here out of the gun. And his throw is going to be incomplete.
Well, anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter, but that time, they were up to the challenge.
This will be the eighth play of the drive. It's 3rd and 7. Back to throw again. He's got his target. That's complete. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. They're able to convert on 3rd down, and that sets up a 1st and goal.
That's a big conversion there on 3rd down, and this has been a great opening drive. You know, at this point, they'd hate to settle for 3, but they've created a fresh set of downs and a 1st and goal.
A terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, 1st and goal. Now he'll try to run with this. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. A great play there. Scoring on the keeper from 6 yards out. And the Falcons will jump on top with the game's 1st score here this afternoon. They gotta love that. 9-play drive results in 6 points.
That means they're doing the dictating. That means that they've described how the game's going to go. They're playing at their tempo, at their pace. If you're on the other side of the ball, if you're playing defense, defense is not methodical. They've got to go in there and shake things up and create a little havoc.
Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback. So here now the Bears offense for their 1st drive of the game. And a look at a guy, definitely got a little razzle-dazzle to him. Can do it with his arm or his legs, their mobile QB.
We're seeing it more and more in this league, how teams love to have athletes back there taking the snaps, guys who can throw it and move around and get yardage with their legs if needed. He's one of the best examples that we see out there right now. He can throw for hundreds of yards 1 week and then run for 100-plus the next. He adds an extra dimension that really confounds defenses when he puts it all together.
This is DeAndre Swift, who, of course, played just up the road in Athens. And he maneuvers up the middle for 3, and it's 2nd down. So they cite the right guard this time with a holding penalty.
And so many different assignments you could have at that position, and sometimes you might just be a step too late and have to grab and hold on.
Now a give, right side, Swift. 4 yards on the pickup, it'll be 2nd down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good 1st down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on 1st down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Williams looking to throw on 2nd down.
I don't see more of them trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. Looking to throw, Williams. And now another one thrown incomplete.
And 3rd down is a key down in any game you play. And 3rd down defense, something we've got to watch in this one. Got to be effective on the passing downs. That's a pretty good 1st step right there.
4th down, so they send out Trenton Gill. Avery Williams deep for Atlanta. It's taken to the 26. We'll call that a 49-yard punt, but a net of just 39 following the 10-yard return. And it will be Falcon football. So for the second time in this one, we get set to see the Falcons offense.
They've got the 7-0 lead. Now they've got the football back after their defense got the stop, CD. And you get the feeling if they could score here, they'd really have all the momentum on their side.
And you just wonder right now, is the quarterback and the play caller totally in sync? Are they of one mind that, hey, what worked last time? Let's keep doing it until they stop us. Or do they go to a different section in the playbook, show them something different? Either way, they want a repeat of their first drive.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. 2nd and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. In trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
On 2nd down, another shot for Robinson.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 12 yards is the pickup. Good for a first down for the Falcons. And if his coaches are correct, we're going to see a lot more runs like that from this young rookie going forward.
And you know, slapping each other on the back up in the boots right now? The scouting department, because they really recommended this guy highly, and he's justifying their faith in him.
On 1st and 10, it's Robinson. He'll work his way up the middle for a gain of about 4, 2nd down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winning in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
2nd and 6. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Throw left side, complete. That's Robinson. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game? That's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a first down.
Straight ahead, it's Robinson.
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Darnell Mooney, the target there.
And it's 3rd down.
They'll be in search of 8 yards here as they hope to convert the first down.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And that is incomplete.
No coverage bust by the defense here. They did a nice job accounting for everybody, and that led to an incompletion.
So on now is the Clemson man, Bradley Pinion, to punt this one away. And this will be out of bounds, and they spot it at the 15-yard line. Not too bad.
Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their 2nd drive of the game.
The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
Williams now throwing to start the drive.
There's a short throw. It's caught by Kmet.
Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that's going to bring up 2nd down. Swift going to try up the middle. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down.
They'll try and run here with Swift. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
That's a tremendous group effort there, because when you talk about offensive lines, the best ones, talk about guys that play in harmony, in sync, and getting things done, and they did that on that play.
Yeah, especially on 3rd and 1, got to be in sync, and they were.
Here's Williams, throwing on 1st down. A gain of 8 there on the play, and that'll bring up a 2nd down in just a couple.
Well, that's always a good place to throw it, just because he's one of the biggest targets, not only on this team, but in the National Football League.
And you and I both know the quarterbacks love these large body tight ends, and why not? Nowadays, they're really wide receivers who are just taller and have a little bit more weight. These guys catch the football, make big plays downfield. In the old days, we wanted them to block. Now coaches want to catch the football first.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first.
Well, they came into this game saying it was important that they set the tone and show that they can run the football. I believe that they've done that here in the first quarter.
From Falcon territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 43. They'll run. This is Khalil Herbert. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Early down stuffs will put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
From the 42 yard line, here's the 2nd and 9.
Back to throw. Williams. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a 3rd down.
I think he had to unload that one before he wanted to. He was right up in his grill. I think he was a dentist there without a license, don't you?
Just not enough time for the play to develop. Just lucky it wasn't a fumble, really.
Now Williams to throw on 3rd down. Able to find the open man. That's complete. Touchdown, Chicago! A great effort there. 42 yards.
And the Bears are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Well, Charles, kind of the future of this franchise on display right there. You had a rookie throwing it, a rookie catching it, and taking it into the end zone.
Could you imagine if we were in the owner's box right now and we could look at the front office and see the grins on their faces to see the present, making plays, and knowing what the future will bring with these youngsters going out and making big-time moments happen for this team.
Santos with the extra point, and we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away.
From the end zone, here comes Williams. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here.
Last series form, a little disappointing, forced to punt. And now they'll try to do better here and come away with some points as they begin this drive, 1st and 10.
They start on the ground with Robinson here. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
When you're lateral to the line of scrimmage, linebackers keep those shoulders square so they can go up and down. But when it's time to go, turn your shoulders just like a running back. Get through the line and hit the runner in the backfield.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw.
This pass is caught by London.
And he'll be out of bounds right at the 40. That one covers 24 yards. It's a first down.
Well, that certainly has to feel good. It's not all the time that the play caller should get all the credit. Sometimes I think in the huddle, the quarterback just says, hey, who's going to make a play for me? I just need something right here. And the end result there, nice first down. Drive keeps moving.
Robinson up the middle, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Tremaine Edmonds, the linebacker, was the one disrupting there defensively.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Here we go on second and 12. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll set up to throw. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
I'll tell you what, these last couple of drives, much better from a defensive perspective. They gave up a touchdown on the opening drive, and then after forcing a punt on their last possession, it looks like they're going to get the football back again.
On now to punt. Here's Bradley Pinion.
And he couldn't get it to check up. That kicks all the way into the end zone for a touchback. Now the Bears offense ready to take over again.
Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time out, Charles. Remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
They'll start on the ground with Swift. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 61 yards rushing for him as he's got the afternoon off to a great start.
I don't care what the game plan was coming in. After these runs,
you're running it, right?
you make sure you keep circling on your play sheet, running plays that are working, and keep patting those big offensive linemen on the back. They're doing a great job.
It goes without saying the defense is going to have to adjust to it.
In a big way, and they've got to figure out, do they have to sell out to stop the run, or can they just do it better than what they've done so far?
The Bears with the football. We get set to begin quarter number two as they've got it with a first and 10. Herbert powering up the middle. And he's over midfield and into Falcon territory. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and 4.
Good yardage there on first down. Exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs. Keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Williams to throw on second down.
That's complete to his running back, Herbert.
So he'll be stopped here for no gain. And now we've got a third down and 3. They couldn't get anything going there out on the right side of the flat of the swing pass.
And didn't we have a discussion with their staff about wanting to get the backs more involved in the
big
passing game? Huge emphasis for this game, but obviously the defense had other plans and really made a nice play.
On third and short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him the third down conversion, 5 yards on the play.
At first glance, I thought he just used his size in order to win the route, but he also had a little subtle move in there as well. Made the defender think he was going one direction and was able to track the ball in another.
On first and 10, it's Swift. And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
A
right back to Swift again on second down.
And he'll take this one down to the 36. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five.
Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Play number seven now coming up on the drive. Third and five. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. Forced out to his left. And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. That gain on third down, good for 28.
Certainly not a positive sign if you're the D coordinator and you see your guys give up that space so early in the game. Third down, that's when the clamps are supposed to come out, but his ability to create things with his legs makes things difficult.
Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Got his man, and it's caught for a Chicago touchdown. A great play there. Two catches, two touchdowns here so far. And the Bears have taken the lead.
There was a lot of zip on that pass, and baseball might have called that a frozen rope.
I like it when you bring the diamond into the game. I'm going back to the gridiron. Had some heat on that bad boy. Sometimes you throw a touchdown pass, and sometimes...
You throw, what, a touchdown strike?
There you go. That's my man, in concert.
Santos able to tack on the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. After the touchdown here, Santos to kick this one away.
And Williams going to sit on this one. It'll be a touchback.
Atlanta now coming out on the field.
That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up two straight touchdowns to fall behind by seven.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe then get this game tied up.
They begin the drive with Robinson. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. They're going to look to throw.
Short throw caught by Pitts.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that'll leave them with a third and two.
They'll come to the line needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. Robinson will try to pick it up.
Well, this is not going to be enough. Was in search of 2 yards and only got halfway there.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Now here's Bradley Pinion now.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Here's Jones.
So a good punt there, but a nice return of 11 yards.
And the Bears take over. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field.
Now their last two drives, both ending in touchdowns. It's got them this 14-7 lead.
And it looks to me, and I think you're probably seeing the exact same thing, they're in an ideal spot now to create some separation. The way that they're functioning on offense now, they can create a pretty good gap allows your defense to play with a little more verve and confidence.
That big article in the paper this morning about them stringing possessions together for consecutive touchdowns. Well, right here, they're trying to make it three in a row. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled. 80 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here in this first half.
I'm not sure how much more evidence they need, partner, than to understand that if they don't start to slow him down, it's going to be a long afternoon here at the stadium because he is just shredding them at this point. And let's face it, coming into the game, they knew he would be the focal point of their attack. This is going to take an 11-man unit on the defensive side to start making plays.
He can rack up those tackles in bunches in the run game from that middle linebacker spot.
And what he has to do is make sure he congratulates the guys in front and tells them thanks a lot, because as the guy in the middle, the Mike linebacker, you're counting on your front three, your front four, your front five, whatever you've got in front of you, to take up all the blocking, allow you to roam and hit, and that's what he did on that play.
He'll get only three there, so it leaves him with a third and seven ahead. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. On third down, Williams. He had a man open, but he missed him, and it's incomplete.
One first down here, and that's all, folks. Good work by this defense to hold things in check and force a punting situation.
Now here's Trenton Gill on to punt. And that'll hit at the five and go into the end zone for a touchback. Here are the Falcons as their offense heads back onto the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
First down, and they'll start with Algier. And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. On the counter, this is Robinson. Oh, good move. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A nice pickup there, 18 yards, first down Falcons. They went counter there offensively, and a couple of defenders were on skates for a second.
They certainly were, and you know what offensive linemen love about the counters and the misdirections? Sometimes you don't have to block the defender. He can run himself out of the play if he doesn't read his keys properly.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Back to throw here. Into the hands of London. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space. And it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
Hand off now to Robinson, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
38-yard line, second and nine. They'll look to throw. And his throw is incomplete. Darnell Mooney, the target there. Third down here. They'll come to the line here needing 9 yards to pick up the first. He'll look to throw. That is incomplete. Brings up fourth down. Solid coverage by the Bears D.
Oh, they'll certainly be on the tablets going over that one for sure.
Clearly, they were expecting something else out of the defense and couldn't adjust to make that completion happen.
So now they're going to send out the field goal unit to, as they say, fire away from long distance. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. That was never in doubt. And they'll cut the lead back down to four now at 14-10.
Well, in a close game like this, obviously you want the touchdown, but certainly they will take the three.
And they'll be okay with that, but let's throw a little credit to the defense as well. I'm just glad this doesn't come down to a debate, right? Which side won, partner? Because the defense, hey, we didn't give up a touchdown. The offense, hey, we put three on the board. Either way you look at it, I think both sides gained something out of that drive.
Let's go, fellas.
The punter, Pinion, now to kick this one away.
No run back here for Jones, a touchback. Well, let's shine the spotlight on the former Georgia Bulldog, DeAndre Swift, who's set to begin this next drive.
He's been good. His guys are winning. So far, the recipe working here in the second quarter.
He doesn't like to just tote the rock. He wants to carry his team on his back, and that's what he's done throughout this game.
Yeah, he's done that. He'll be hoping to continue that trend.
On the ground, it's Swift to start the drive.
And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39.
97 yards on the ground here for Swift. He's got a first down as well.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
They go play action here on first down. And this one is incomplete.
Definitely worth taking another deep shot here. He's already found the end zone twice here in the first half.
Yeah, go back to that same well. They've had trouble containing him, but able to contain him on that play. So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10.
And they'll try to run the option here.
Williams loses the football.
Well, one of the linebackers has got it.
And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. He had the option there, decided to keep it, exposed himself and fumbled it.
Yeah, and you worry about the hits he's going to take in that situation. In this case, not only does he take the hit, he coughs the ball up, as you noted.
The Falcons ready to take over. Last time out, you remember their drive stalled, but thanks to their kicker, booted a long field goal to at least get them three. Now here they'll try to do better and find the end zone.
And in our experience, how much fun is it for coaches to know that they've got a kicker who can nail it from long distance? Now the hard part is, as an offensive play caller, you don't want that in your head too much where you're relying on it, and he goes out and gets the job done for them. But I'm quite sure he would be content to just kick extra points from here on out.
Yeah, absolutely, no question. I think his teammates would be okay with him just kicking the extra points as well.
17 yards and a first down for Atlanta right after the turnover they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. That is caught at the 7. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. Another first down as he went right back to the same well, this time for 17 yards.
And remember, this drive started off following the turnover, and they've taken no time working their way down the short field. A nice connection there, and now they're looking at a first and goal.
They'll run here with Algier.
And he gets him a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4. Be interesting to see now what they do offensively down near the goal line after not much there that time.
As the offensive play caller, that may change your sequence now. Instead of coming right back with a running play, you may have to go to the air.
Second and goal from inside the 5. They'll motion out one of the tight ends.
Robinson, not going anywhere. He'll lose a couple back to the 6.
It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a third down. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Steps away to his left. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1 yard line. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts.
So as they talk it over, we step aside. Fourth down, and the attention turns to Falcon kicker Younghoe Koo.
From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle.
Koo knocks this one through the post.
And the lead is down to one now at 14-13.
So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away.
Jones now on the return.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. He might take this all the way. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Bears.
I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him. Kick it to him. The way he runs as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there.
Now the point after try for Santos. And with that, the lead is up to 8. And no doubt one of the most, if not the most, exciting play we'll see in this game. The kick return all the way to the end zone for 6 points. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
And we will not see an attempt to match that return touchdown, as this will be a touchback and bring it out to the 25. Time to get another look at Drake London and the Falcons' offense,
making his presence felt early in this one. First half, already over the century mark.
How about the yards per completion, too? That's a pretty darn good number there. Number of catches, but he's shredding defenses, getting big yardage with each and every one of them.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
They decided the opportunity was there and launched a deep ball, but he was unable to get away from the defender, couldn't create space, couldn't uncover at the end of the route, and that one winds up incomplete.
Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25. Back to throw. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bear sack.
Montez Sweat, the man that time to fight in and drop him.
But defensively on the previous play, they gave up a pretty good chunk of yardage, but right there, they got a good portion of it right back.
And if we just flip it around from the offensive perspective, took a nice step forward, and how about a couple of leaps backwards after that play? They've got to figure out a big call coming.
And he's going to go down again. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts.
as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. On the give, here's Robinson. And they'll indeed stop him on third down. And now what do you want to do with your timeouts? Now a timeout called for by the defense as they stop it here with just under 40 ticks to go in this first half. Here's Bradley Pinion now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. Jones on the return. It'll be a 44-yard punt. The return goes for eight. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Bears going to get one more possession in this first half. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
30 seconds remain in this first half as they come up here first and 10. Throwing to start the drive, Williams. And he can't escape, and down he goes.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face, not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey. So we reach halftime with the visiting Bears out on top here as we send you down to Orlando where Jonathan Coachman has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much, and welcome in everyone to our downtown Orlando studios in this EA Sports Halftime Report. We were certainly treated to an entertaining first half, both these teams with some high points and maybe a couple of low points as well. So it's going to be a question of who can be the most disciplined team going forward.
Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A one touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. And tackled at the 21-yard line, so a net negative there of 4 yards. So here's the Bears offense now as they get set to start this third quarter. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they've got the lead now, a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, and believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too. Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
Now they'll fake it there on the jet sweep, and instead, here's Swift. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustment, what they talked about, maybe it's just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
Out of the gun now on third down. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Disrupting that play and dropping him was Arnold Ebikadi.
To me, the defense was looking a little gassed near the end of the first half, but they've come out of the locker room with a little extra spring in their step. Wonder what they did at halftime to get them so motivated.
I don't know, but that sack looked good. Now let's see if they can build on the momentum of that play. Here comes the Bears punter now, standing right on his own 5-yard line. And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And the Falcons will be taking over first and 10. Off to start it out, Robinson. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
Nice chunk of yards on first down. It really opens up your options for what you want to do on second. You go right back to him and hope he explodes, or sucker the defense in before throwing over the top.
From the 39-yard line, here comes second down at 6. They'll look to throw here. Throw left side, there's London. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 7 catches for him now, and this last one, a first down.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Caught out left side by Robinson. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
Ball on the 40 now. Here's 2nd and 2. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And that's going to be too high, out of bounds and incomplete.
Well, partner, I think the defensive fellas got the memo, and they decided to cover him on that play.
Yeah, he's already up over 100 yards in this game. They tried a deep shot, couldn't get him.
Yeah, when you've had that much success, finally, someone said, let's try and put a stop to it and put people on him.
On 3rd down, Robinson. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 55 yards on the ground for him now as he's done that on 15 carries.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been 4-down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, though, if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
They try and run on first down, but this one going to lose a couple yards as they get him behind the line.
Well, partner, I guess sometimes it's just a matter of philosophy. Some say run until they absolutely stop you, and others say, well, when you think they're about to stop you, fool them a little bit. I guess they should have tried to fool them on that play.
Now they contend with a 2nd and 12 after the loss. Robinson with another carry. Works his way inside the 30 on a pickup of 4.
On any running play that's called, they're always hoping that it's going to break big and go the distance. But when you get a nice gain like that, you're able to do so many things anyway. You can come back and run essentially the same play again, continue to move the ball on the ground, or you can decide to throw the ball now because usually you have the defense back on its heels.
Looking to throw. And that is incomplete. Brings up 4th down, solid coverage by the Bears D.
How about this defense? They came up with a couple big plays in this sequence, and none better than the one right there, forcing the incompletion and bringing up 4th down.
And we'll see Younghoe Koo now for the Falcons. From the right hash, it's a 46-yard attempt. Koo knocks this one through the post, and that'll get the lead down to 5. He's got 9 points on field goals now. He's made three of them. That gets him a bit closer, but there's no question they need to start turning some of these threes into sixes.
And for him, it's not his concern, right? He just goes out there when they call on him and goes ahead and puts points up on the board. But the offense has got to get together and figure out what's stalling their drives so they have to keep calling on him.
The punter Pinion now to kick this one away. Here's Jones to bring it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Bears offense now gets set to head back onto the field. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least 2 first downs, because even if you have to punt then, you change the field position, right? You flip the field a little bit. They didn't get that done. This time they want to string together a nice drive and help themselves out.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
What a way to start a drive. An excellent run, a tone setter, and now if you want to take a shot on second down and go play action and make it look like the same exact play and throw it over the top, you can do so because you've established the run in a big way.
In motion, right goes Allen. Right back to Swift again on second down. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Here comes third and about a foot. They'll run with Herbert. And he's able to get the first before he's taken down at the 36. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Brandon, they're still in the lead, but momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence, and you're right. They need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped. On first down, right back to Herbert. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. That time, the right guard sending him backwards.
And so many different types of guys rotate in on the defensive line now, depending on situations. You can get the bulky guy, the fast guy. No matter what, though, you can't hold them.
On the option to give to Swift here. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Right back to Swift again on second down. And the defense on him quickly there as they stop him at the 40 for a gain of just 2.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Third down and 6. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Arnold Ebikadi able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Like how they've started the third quarter here. They force a punt on the first drive, and after this sack, it looks like they'll be forcing another one as well.
Absolutely. Maybe got their second win coming out of the locker room. Here comes the Bears punter now. He's been terrific so far. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. On the return is Williams. Following the punt return here, there is someone shaken up. Hopefully, obviously, nothing serious here. Medical staff, though, going to take a peek, and we'll take a break. the Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six.
2 yards to go, second down.
On play action, they'll throw. Short throw caught by Pitts. And he maybe makes it back to the line of scrimmage. That's it. So they'll get nothing out of that play. And it makes it third down and 2 yards to go.
As a defense, you're more balanced when you're in zone coverage because you're able to keep your eyes on the quarterback and see the play develop in front of you. They're able to keep the quick pass in front of them and stop it right at the line of scrimmage.
Straight ahead, it's Robinson. And strong running there as he's across midfield and down to the 49. It's a gain of 11, and the Falcons pick up the first.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick and shifty, can make moves, make people miss, but also gets to and through a hole before it can close down. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get it.
And that is caught at the 10-yard line. Touchdown, Falcons. Kyle Pitts, 49 yards. And the Falcons have retaken a third quarter lead.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Now Arthur Smith going to tell the offense to stay put. We're going for two.
They'll try and throw for it. And they don't get it. They tried for the two-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. And in the third quarter here, they were trying to push that to a three-point game, but instead it'll stay at one.
And I'm a big proponent of not chasing points or going for two too early. But in this case, I understand why. You know, if you kick an extra point, you're just up two, right? So a field goal still puts the other team ahead. So you go for two here and protect the field goal lead. They didn't get it done, though.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. Oh, the return is Jones from the end zone. And ultimately, he stopped right where he would have been if he had simply gone down to a knee at the 25. Another drive coming up for this Chicago offense. See if they can put this drive in the end zone, Charles, because it's been a little bit of a rough go at times. They've had to punt the football a ton in this ball game because of stalled out drives.
So are you saying that you're kind of tired of seeing the punter run out there and do his thing during this game? Is that what you're trying to say?
Well, I mean, I'm okay with it. I have a feeling that this offense, they don't want to see the punter again.
And frankly, the punter doesn't want to run out there anymore himself. He would love to see his offense put together a drive and give his leg a rest. Well, they always talk about playing great team defense, and that was an excellent example right there. Everyone on assignment, no one in the wrong spot, everyone filling their gaps.
Williams now looking to throw on second down.
There's a short throw. It's caught by Kmet,
and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch. And now that sets up third and two. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
They'll try and run for it. Here's Johnson. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a fourth down.
I think what we just saw there, partner, was linebacking speed that can trump O-line power. We see that at times because he filled the gap before the offensive lineman could get to the next level and take him on.
Here comes the Bears punter now, as he's on for the fifth time here today. Here's Williams to return. It's a 45-yard punt, but a decent return there of 9 yards.
And it will be Falcon football.
Atlanta prepped and readied for its next possession. And they'll just simply be looking to build off the confidence of the last time out where they scored a touchdown.
And confidence is powerful, isn't it? When you've scored once, you feel like you can go back out there and get it done again. Doesn't matter what the defense throws at them, they feel like they're in a groove right now, and they want to get out there and show it.
Yeah, hoping to stay in that groove here this go around. They start on the ground with Robinson here. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. 15 yards, first down, Atlanta.
Now that was an excellent run. And when you see that happen, that's when you're seeing guys doing their job and then some people doing a little bit more. Offensive linemen and tight ends, they're expected to block. But the wide receivers, all they want to do is catch passes. So when they block on a big-time running play and create extra space, you've got to hit the jackpot there.
And they're not going to get to the line to run another play. So we will switch ends as the third quarter has come to a close. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now in Atlanta. And we've got a dandy here. A one-point game as we begin the fourth. Back to throw now on first down. Throw over the middle. Going to be caught here by Pitts. So the completion good for 6 yards. And it's second down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
From just shy of midfield, here's second and 4. Robinson up the middle. There's Robinson showing the flash. And he'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. That burst good for 20 and a first down.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
Now a play fake here on first down. That's caught left side to tight end Pitts. Short completion, just 4 yards, and it'll be second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Second and 6. And it's caught. Touchdown, Falcons. Drake London, 26 yards. And the Falcons get an important score there to extend their lead here this fourth quarter. They have to love seeing that from their young quarterback here in the fourth quarter, able to further that lead with a touchdown pass.
He didn't go turtle, did he? And you know what I mean by that. I had an old coach used to say all the time, hey, when we have a lead late, don't just tuck in and try and ride it out. Go out and play and extend the lead. And that's what he did.
Ku able to connect on the extra point. And that will ensure that it will take a touchdown and a two-point conversion to tie it. Following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And
this will come out to the 25 as Jones elects for the touchback. The Bears offense out there set and ready to go. Still plenty of time here in the fourth quarter. Just a one possession game, down 8. They'll be looking for the touchdown and 2-point conversion. A field goal here on this drive does very little at this stage. Here's Williams, throwing to start the drive. There's a short throw, it's caught by Komet. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first.
And that's a much needed first down right there. Look, they're down by 8. So logic says they don't have to get a touchdown out of this drive. But the way things are going, I don't know if I'd put it in the hands of my defense here. You might not get the ball back at all. So if a fourth down situation comes up, I'm thinking hard about going for it right here and right now.
And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down.
Good strong run against the 3-4 set. And that 3-4, you've got to have your guys up front eat up a lot of blocks. The guy playing over the center, the nose, he usually has to take on double teams. But when you're able to successfully move him, you're often able to get some yardage. And that's when linebackers have to clean up and make tackles.
And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
And they really needed to get something going, didn't they? They had punted on the last 2 possessions. The running game starting to come to the front for them, providing a nice pickup there to keep this drive going.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Williams throw complete here to Komet. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on first down, hitting the tight end there. Now it brings up a second and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. And from the 42 now, here's second and 2. Looking to throw. Williams. Oh, he'll want that one back. Incomplete. He doesn't drop too many in that department. Third down. Fair to say, hasn't been his best game throwing the football, but also not getting a lot of help out there either.
Yeah, you nailed it pretty well, you know. He's got to throw it better, got to get more help. Obviously one that should have been caught, they got to find a way to bring those two elements together so they can make some progress in this one.
And boy, from up here, I don't think Johnson got there. No, he did not. That'll bring up fourth. They had the 8-yard gain on first down, but unable to do much from there.
And they have just not been able to block him at all throughout this game. Seems like every other play, he's doing something in the backfield. Already got 2 sacks, and now here's a tackle behind the line.
Here comes the Bears punter now, as they're forced to kick for the 6th time today. Too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. And here now come the Falcons. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. They begin the drive with Robinson, and he is brought down at the 22 after a gain of 2, and it brings up second down.
I like that run right there, partner. Not the flashiest run, not the one that's going to break for big yardage, but he understands the situation, and taking care of the football, paramount, and he got it done.
Nursing that slim lead, you're exactly right. Hold on to that ball. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. That's complete to the tight end Warner. And he is out of bounds right around the 34. Now we're going to get a stoppage. Appears to be an injured Bear on the field. While they come out and take a look at him, we will step aside for just a moment. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. trying the left side with Algier. And this defense able to plug him up there as he'll get a yard to the 35.
I like a guy who understands the situation. I also like a guy who you look at him and you say, that looks like a guy who knows the coach is going to say, guess what? You drop this one, you'll be carrying around the training facility for an entire week.
Maybe flashback to high school or college, carrying it around campus, right?
Maybe the old gauntlet drill, right? Anyone get the ball out while he's sitting in class and bring it back to the coach?
Bottled up, fumble. It's out. It's loose. And this is picked up by the Bears. Down the numbers. There he goes. And they bring this one back. A fumble return for a Bears touchdown.
So they were down by a touchdown, probably just hoping the defense could hold them, maybe force the punt. Instead, they forced the turnover and take it into the house.
Well, the plan was perfect. That's exactly what they wanted. Instead, they got a lot more than that. Big-time capitalization by taking the ball away and putting it in the end zone.
Here we go now as we get set for a big two-point conversion. They're going to try and run for it. And he will get into the end zone for two. And this game now tied here in the fourth. Still time to work with on the clock, but they wanted the tie now, and they got it.
And I love their aggressiveness. Go ahead and get it done. Get the game tied. Now your team has the momentum, and you're staring across the field saying, let's see if you can match us.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the fourth as the kick's away. On the return, Williams. And able to get this across the 20, but not much further as he's dropped at the 23-yard line.
Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here.
Excellent job by their defense to force the punt and provide them with this opportunity. All tied in the fourth quarter.
They'll look to throw now on first down.
He'll get this complete to Rondale Moore.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 30 yards there.
Well, this game has certainly had no shortage of offense. Both teams have been revved up from the start. And here's yet another big play. Boy, both defenses have just got to be dragging out there because they've been run ragged throughout.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. He'll look to throw.
And he'll go right back to Moore, complete again. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Boy, a pair of big plays here. This one going for 29.
That connection seemed to work out okay on the first play of the drive. Why not go right back to it? And once again, this defense is left without an answer as they surrender back-to-back first downs.
So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
Someone moved, flag is out, that's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
Expect this from the visiting team when playing indoors, but not the home team.
They're supposed to get all the advantages, right? The home crowd's supposed to help them. They forgot where they were, perhaps.
A false start backs them up 5, first and 15. Back to throw here.
A caught by London. So the completion results there in 9 yards, and that'll make it second down.
Thank you.
They'll look to throw again. Throws right back to London. Complete again. And the Falcons are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves him all the way down to the one.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, you just need the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
Algier is into the end zone. It's a Falcons touchdown. Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play and actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on the stat sheet, but you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
Now Youngway Koo for the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now. The drive summary that time, 5 plays.
And it was Tyler Algier capping things off with a touchdown.
Now Pinion with a kickoff honors following the touchdown. No run back here for Jones, a touchback. The Chicago offense set to get started. And now after the touchdown a moment ago, they work from behind in a 7-point game in this fourth quarter. Plenty of time on the clock. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Now Williams to throw on second down. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. That'll go as a pickup of 32 on the catch and run.
Well, if you're a fan of offensive football, this game is for you because this one's been much more like a tennis match than a football game. Back and forth, back and forth. And there's another example right there of another big play in the passing game.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. That's complete to his running back, Herbert. Yeah, this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Second down and a little more than a yard here. Off play action, Williams. And that is incomplete.
Just because you've got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
The Bears on third down. They've converted 5 times in their many chances thus far. They need just a yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Evans is caught. He hits Moore. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to convert by plenty there on 3rd and 1.
I don't care how many times we say it, I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
Officially, no gain on the play, and it's 2nd down. He's having a big game running the football, but that will hurt the yards per carry a little bit.
Yeah, but the average he's got so far, that's the type of average he wants to take with him to contract negotiations, doesn't he?
2nd and 10. Back to throw. Williams. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
We've seen this quite a few times in this game. Offensive line unable to keep leverage, unable to keep people away, facing a lot of pressure. Fortunate just to get rid of it.
One of the reasons they're down is that inability, though, to stop the pressure. We saw another example of it there.
Williams on third down, letting one go deep for the end zone. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Trying to get a big strike right there and hopefully tie this game up in the late going. But the coverage was there, and this winds up incomplete.
So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. From the left hash, this from 39. Santos' kick is up and through, and that'll bring him back within four.
So an interesting call there to take the three. I mean, I guess they're thinking that their hands were tied, but, you know, fourth quarter, that field goal might not help them that much in the end.
Yeah, eventually they're going to need the touchdown. The thinking must have been they didn't feel confident about picking it up there, hoping maybe on defense they can get better field position, get a turnover, get a better play, and then they'll have a chance to attack the end zone.
After the made field goal, Santos back out there to kick it away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Here comes the Falcon offense now as they get set to take over here. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all of our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here.
They'll try and start this drive in the air. His throw incomplete.
I like the calmness of how he played the ball here. No panic in his eyes as that throw arrived. Tracked it from the moment it left the quarterback's hand, and that's just where he needed to be to knock it away.
Here's second and 10. A give left side to Robinson. And he'll manage only a couple here up to the 25.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. Now, this is a big third down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop them here.
Short throw caught by Pitts. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32.
And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he's on to punt for Atlanta. Here's Jones on the return. 51 yards on the punt there.
And they will take over first and 10.
So now the Bears down by four. A minute 44 to go. They need a touchdown. A field goal is worthless now as they come up on first and 10. To throw. Finding Allen. And he's going to get out of bounds with the first down. So that's going to double their pleasure for sure. They get the first and save a timeout.
They got exactly what they wanted there. Out route, catch, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
And I have to criticize defense here because you know the situation. You want to keep them in bounds and have the clock run. So I'm sitting on the outside portion of the field and not letting them throw an out route. Throw anything inside and I'll make the tackle. An out route? That's not the way you're supposed to play it.
And they get him down
but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. This is where you learn a lot about rookie quarterbacks. How can they run that two-minute drill? We're about to find out.
Yeah, and for them, it's not just proving it to guys like you and me watching the game and trying to beat a defense. It's proving it to their teammates that they can have the confidence in them when they line up in these situations.
Williams' throw there complete to Allen.
It drives some people crazy to see those short throws underneath. They've got to find a way to gash the defense downfield.
They come up now on second and two.
He'll look to throw.
Yeah, quick throw there is incomplete.
Now we're in the situation where the quarterback's got to take full charge of his huddle. Got to totally command and make sure all eyes are on him. All focus is locked in. Going to call multiple plays and go over different situations and scenarios to make sure everyone is on the same page.
Back to throw.
Pass taken in by his big tight end.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. Now the Bears going to use the second of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
Final minute, one timeout remaining. First and 10.
He's back to throw.
Oh, that is incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
And that's out to the flat for Swift.
And a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10. Now the Bears will use their third and final timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game.
The sound reverberating here in the dome. This is third down.
They'll look to throw.
He's got his running back out of the backfield. And the Bears are going to have first and goal coming up as they're able to convert there on third and two. Came so close, Charles. They were knocking on the door in a one-possession game, but ultimately the defense held tough to get the victory.
And doesn't it feel like it just leaves them asking what could have been? So many moments when they could have had a big play to change the outcome of this game, and let's face it, none bigger than that final snap that just fell short.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.